लेट हो गए
थोड़ा सा, लेकिन अभी अभी भी टाइम है ना थोड़ा सा. आप लोग हमारे लिए माइक आपने पकड़ा हुआ है, तो मैं सामान ले आया हूँ सब, ठीक है.
इनको डायरेक्शंस कुछ नहीं पता है, तो
वो मैं गूगल मैप्स पे, गूगल मैप्स पे डिपेंड कर रहा था, ठीक है. पर अभी आप लोग हमारे साथ हैं तो गूगल बंद कर देते हैं एंड मैं आपके साथ डिलीवरी शुरू करें.
ओके, लेट्स गो.
नहीं मैं लेता हूँ, आप चलिए. मैं सबको बता देता हूँ कि ये दोनों बैग्स में सैनिटरी पैड्स हैं, राइट एलेक्स?
यप. सो दैट्स द आइडिया. वी कमिंग फ्रॉम द माइना फाउंडेशन एंड दैट एसेंशियली इज एन एनजीओ दैट हैज बीन मेकिंग एंड सेलिंग अफोर्डेबल सैनिटरी पैड्स एंड एवेंजलाइजिंग द आइडिया ऑफ द यूज ऑफ सैनिटरी
पैड्स. एंड आई थिंक द बिगेस्ट प्रॉब्लम एंड द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज is to spread awareness about this. Now, we've all watched the movie Padman and we've all watched those YouTube videos and those TEDx talks and all of that. But these are people who are doing this every day on the ground. And we thought, considering this week, earlier this week, we celebrated World Menstrual Health Day. It's important to talk about some of these things. And we thought the best way to do it is to actually go with Archana ji and Deborah and figure out what problems they face. Jo main jab aap delivery ke liye jaate hain ya fir kisi ko समझाने के लिए कि ये आपका प्रोडक्ट क्या है, इसकी ज़रूरत क्या है, अहमियत क्या है, तो आपको मेन प्रॉब्लम क्या, मतलब मेन प्रॉब्लम क्या होती है?
सबसे मेन प्रॉब्लम तो हमको ये क्रिएट होती है कि जो पहले ज़माने के सोच है, जैसे ये बस्तियों में हम लोग आते हैं तो लोग बोलते हैं हम परंपरा से कपड़ा यूज़ कर रहे हैं, आप लोग आके पैड दे के लोगों को बिगाड़ रहे हैं. तो उनको वो नहीं पता कि कपड़ा यूज़ करने से उनको कितना नुकसान है. तो ये हम लोग समझाते हैं. जैसे आप अपने ऊपर पान के ऊपर या अपने कपड़े के ऊपर हर महीने के आप 300-400 रुपया खर्चा कर सकते हो, तो खुद पे 40 रुपया हर महीने में खर्चा करने में क्या दिक्कत है. तो ऐसे हम हर बस्ती में जाके उनको समझाते हैं. तो ठीक है, आप पहली बार वो लोग नहीं लेते हैं, हम ठीक है आप एक बार लेके तो देखो, भले हमारा ब्रांड नहीं, कौन सा भी ब्रांड यूज़ करो पर पैड यूज़ करो. तो एक पैकेट हम लोग दे देते हैं उनको, समझाते हैं ऐसे.
और जब वो एब्सोल्युटली ना कहते हैं कि हमें यूज़ नहीं करना है, तभी आप इन्फॉर्म करते हैं कि कैसे आप इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं?
हाँ, नहीं एक्चुअली क्या हो जाता है, जब हम लोग दे देते हैं उनको और वो नहीं बोल देते, मना करते, निकल के हम बाजू वाले के घर में चले जाते हैं, उनको पैड अगर उन्होंने खरीद लिया उनको समझा देते और उनको ये बता दें हम लोग कि आपके बाजू वाले को बोल देना, तो वो पैड यूज़ करने के बाद में खुद बाजू वाले को बोलती है भाई ये पैड बहुत अच्छा लगा मेरे को, एक बार तू भी इस्तेमाल करके देख. ऐसा करके ही हमने आज बस्तियों में, काफ़ी बस्तियों में हमने कवर किए.
अच्छा जी, आपको भी ऐसे लगता है कि आपको बहुत मुश्किल होती है, क्योंकि एक तो सोच बदलना ज़रूरी है कुछ हद तक. ये हमें मानना पड़ेगा कि एटलीस्ट जो ज़्यादातर लोग हैं इंडिया में, गांव विलेजेस में तो फिर भी अभी ये बात हमें लोगों को समझानी है, लेकिन जैसे पैडमैन पिक्चर के बाद अभी लोग इस बातचीत शुरू हो गई है, लोग शर्मा नहीं रहे, लोग समझने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. वो आपको लगा है थोड़ा सा फ़र्क पड़ा है?
हाँ, फ़र्क पड़ा है, क्योंकि हम लोग देखते हैं कि लोग बोलते हैं कि अभी तो आदमी लोग भी बात कर लेते हैं इस पर कि हाँ अक्षय कुमार की मूवी, अक्षय कुमार इस चीज़ के लिए बोल सकते तो हम लोग क्यों नहीं बोल सकते करके. और पैड यूज़ करना कोई छुपाने की बात तो है नहीं है, वो नेचुरल है ये सब चीज़ें, तो अभी तो कोई शर्माते हैं भी नहीं.
मगर डेफिनेटली आपने कोई इंटरेस्टिंग कहानी एक्सपीरियंस की होंगी, मतलब इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिलीवरिंग दिस, व्हाट इज़ द मोस्ट इंटरेस्टिंग दैट यू कैन टेल अस?
एक्चुअली हम लोग एक लल्लूभाई में गए थे, एक हम लोगों का सेलिंग चल रहा था वहाँ पे, एक घर में गए, दरवाज़ा ठोके, उन्होंने बोला कि एक आदमी आया, जेंट्स आया, तो मैं बोली सर लेडीज़ है क्या घर में, तो बोले नहीं क्या काम है करके बोली है. मैं बोली सर जी मुझे लेडीज़ से काम है, आप उनको बुला दीजिए मुझे उनसे काम है करके. तो बोले कि नहीं ये करके आप मुझसे पूछिए करके. ठीक है, मैं बोली आप पैड यूज़ करते? तो वो जना फिर अंदर चुपचाप से चले गए, फिर वो लेडीज़ आए अंदर, अब बाहर आए और वो बोले अपने एकदम सही सवाल उनको पूछे करके.
So that's what you call a good sales pitch.
And that's perhaps what may be in store for us on this journey with them. Guys, we're going to go and actually make a couple of deliveries and then have a conversation as to how some of these pads are manufactured, how they managed to make it so affordable and how they're doing something with a purpose. Chalne delivery kare?
Yeah, let's go.
यहाँ पे पैड बिका कि नहीं?
जी नहीं, उनके पास अभी है इस तरह, तो बोले हम पर्ची आपकी लेते हैं, दोबारा आपको कॉल करेंगे तो बुलाएंगे.
ठीक है, अभी अगले घर में चलते हैं. चलिए.
ऑलराइट. But then the good thing is that they are using pads and that they have a store of it, and
that's
which
right.
is why they've not taken.
ये महीना का पैड यूज किया आपने? पहली बार कर रहे हो? ये बार अगर चाहिए रहेगा फ्लायर्स दो. आप देखिए ये कैसा है करके इसका सैंपल देखिए अपने. ऐसा है. कॉटन ही है पूरा. आपको जब भी चाहिए रहेगा ना फोन की दीजिए.
करना हम लोग लेके
यहाँ पे आपको घर तक मिल जाएगा. डिलीवरी हो जाएगी. बिक गया. सेल हो गया.
New customer, congratulations.
Yes, new customer.
Congratulations, Archer.
Thank
Ranji.
You.
But and main चीज़ है कि आपने एक flyer भी दे दिया. मतलब अभी याद रहेगा उनको.
हाँ, याद रहेगा. और उनको जब भी ज़रूरत पड़ेगी तो वो फ़ोन करेंगे.
Myna को ही फ़ोन करेंगे.
Myna को ही फ़ोन करेंगे.
Okay, let's find out what else is happening. I think they've been trying to sell more here, Aayush. Let's go find out.
Clearly, Alex, it's not easy.
खाला का क्या यूज़ करते हो खाला? अच्छा, आपने Myna का कभी पैड यूज़ किए हैं? पहली बार है. बताना ज़रा अपना रहा. ये देखो, ये हमारा एक्सेल है और ये हमारा डबल एक्सेल है. पतला है लेकिन बहुत अच्छे से अब्सॉर्ब करता है. तो आप एक बार यूज़ कर लीजिए. और ये फ्लायर्स आपके रखिए. आपको जब भी चाहिए रहेगा इस पर नंबर दिया हुआ है. आपको घर पर डिलीवरी मिल जाएगी. ला के दे देंगे.
कितने सारे लोग मिलते हैं जो पैड्स यूज नहीं करते हैं?
4 से 5 लोग ऐसे निकल जाते हैं अगर 20-25 घर भी अगर हम लोग ये करते हो. और एक औरत हमारे घर में कम से कम 100 के ऊपर घर सर सेलिंग के लिए चले जाते हैं. उसमें से 10-12 तो ऐसे निकल ही जाते हैं जो कॉटन यूज कर लेते हैं.
और ऐसे भी होंगे कि मतलब जब बाहर जाते हैं वो उस टाइम पे यूज करते हैं और घर पे जब रहते हैं.
ऐसे भी लोग मिलते हैं.
okay.
जैसे कि अभी वो लोग कहीं पे अगर कॉलेज लड़की लोग हैं या जॉब पे जाने वाले लेडीज लोग हैं तो वो लोग ऑफिस के लिए जाते वक्त पैड यूज करते हैं और घर में अगर रहेंगे तो कपड़ा यूज करते हैं. ऐसे 1-2 केसेस हम लोगों को मिल चुके हैं.
तो उस टाइम पे क्या बताते हैं मतलब?
हम लोग वही मैंने तो एक बार फ़र्क पूछा था उनको कि बाहर जाते हो आप पैड यूज़ करते हो और घर पे रहते हुए कपड़ा क्यों यूज़ करते करके. या फिर तो उन्होंने एक जन ने बोला कि पैड
एक्सपेंसिव
होते हैं, हम लोग खरीद नहीं पाते करके, तो बाहर जाने जैसा. तो फिर मैंने बोला तो फिर ये तो बच्चे लोगों के जैसा हो गया. अगर बच्चे लोगों को बाहर लेके जाना है कहीं पे तो हगीज पहना दो और लेके चले गए.
ये जो आपने अभी जो बेचे तो 3 वैरायटी के हैं हमारे पास Myna में, है ना?
डबल एक्सेल और रेगुलर.
जी, तो जो सबसे ज्यादा बिकता है वो मेरे हिसाब से सबसे जो अफोर्डेबल होगा सबसे सस्ता वाला वो बिकता है?
नहीं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, लेकिन सबसे ज्यादा हमारा एक्सेल वाला बिकता है.
एक बात बताइए मुझे बस, ताकि हमारे दर्शकों को समझ में आए कि जो सबसे सस्ता वाला हमारा जो पैकेट है. बोला जी आप भी आए, आप तो ऑपरेशन सब समझती हैं. सबसे सस्ता वाला एक कस्टमर को कितने का पड़ा?
जो एक्सेल जाता है हमारा वो 45 में. जैसे कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स रहते हैं जो ऐसे स्लम में है जो अफोर्ड नहीं कर पाते, उनको हम 35 में भी दे देते हैं.
okay.
30 में भी दे देते हैं.
हाँ.
मतलब पैसे का ये
मकसद
नहीं है हमारा.
नहीं है.
पैड यूज कर एक बार हैबिट हो जाएगा तो वो 40-80 रुपीस का भी खरीद लेंगे.
जस्ट ताकि सब लोग समझे कि ये कंपैरिजन में मतलब मार्केट में क्या चल रहा है. इतने सालों से जो बिग ब्रांड्स हैं स्टे फ्री विस्पर, अगर वहाँ से अगर हम एक पैड खरीदें उतने ही पैड कितने के आएंगे?
जो हमारा पैड है पर पीस हम आके 5 रुपीस के नीचे, जैसे 3.5 या 3.4.
ये टॉप क्वालिटी वाले?
टॉप क्वालिटी वाले, फुल्ली कॉटन ही है. उसमें वुड पल्प है, जेल शीट है.
जी. और स्टे फ्री में वो एक पैड कितने का आएगा पर कॉस्ट
के हिसाब से? वो 5. मैंने मेरे अंदाज से मैंने जितना निकाला है 5.6 के ऊपर ही जा रहा है वो.
आई थिंक इट्स
इंपॉर्टेंट स्ट्रेट वाला, नॉट ट्रिपल फोर्ड वाला. स्ट्रेट वाला हम ये ट्रिपल फोर्ड वाला दे रहे हैं जो 5 रुपीस में.
और इसमें वैरायटीज बहुत सारे होते हैं जो विंग्स होते हैं.
एंड दैट्स एग्जैक्टली व्हाट मी डेबोरा जी, अगर हम अभी Myna के ऑफिस में जाएं तो आप लोग हमें समझा सकेंगे कि ये आपके पूरा जो ये पूरा जो Myna का जो वेंचर है इसका मकसद क्या है? और तो और हम वो अफोर्डेबिलिटी कैसे करते हैं और ये आप लोग की सोच है इसके पीछे कौन है, समझा देंगे हमको?
पक्का समझा.
ऑलराइट गाइस, लेट्स गो देयर.
लेट्स हेड आउट.
Hi, Sahani.
Aayush, nice to meet you.
We've been very busy, I must say. We've been out on a delivery and we got a few new customers for you. So,
Really? That sounds wonderful.
Well, we piled on, but yeah, we were a little late as well, as always. But we had a great day, Alex.
Yeah. And so I want to understand, it's a great setup that you have.
Yeah.
Trying to get an idea of how it works, but mm-hmm. how did it start and when did it start? You're 23.
Yeah, I think it started when I was 15, so probably even younger. But, it started with this like incredible group of women who had been working with and doing a lot of research projects with on sanitation. And it was with these wonderful community leaders who I met then, who would tell me all these stories about, you know, women that had to take constipation pills just because there was a distance that they needed to walk to a public toilet, and men would count the number of times that they would go to the toilet. They would hold these pails of water in their hands and they'd be sexually assaulted on the way to a toilet. Yeah. I mean, you often see that women are compromising on their health for dignity. And they wouldn't then go to the toilet. They would time it and so on. And a lot of these stories that I'd constantly heard time and again, and you'd hear these like 14-year-old girls still getting married off. These stories were unheard. They're happening in the center of Mumbai. This is not talking about Rajasthani village or a Haryanvi village. This is talking about an urban slum in Mumbai. Right. And that too, one of the best slums, which is Dharavi. So that's where I was in 2011, working with Dr. Jokin Arpitam, who's been really my mentor this whole time, who started this organization called Mahila Milan, which does a lot of work on savings and self-help groups. And we started working with him and his women. Those women that I met on my first day there are the same directors of Myna Mahila Foundation today, and who we started with 5 years later. So up until then, we were kind of just doing a lot of research projects on toilets and sanitation, rural sanitation, urban sanitation. And we realized that we needed to do something that was more actionable and something particularly for women.
Okay.
And that's why we call this organization Myna Mahila Foundation, because we wanted an organization for women that would help them talk about the things that they're most afraid to discuss aloud, like the chatty Mena word, about their Mahina, like a Mena.
Got it. That makes sense. I think Alex and I were getting the pronunciation wrong. I'm glad you corrected us at this point in the show. But also, I want to figure this out, because I'm seeing this tray out here, Sohani. This is the product, all right? This is what puts you on the map globally for this lovely thing that you're doing. And these are different varieties now, and it goes from the basic to something very premium as well, but you've made it all affordable. How have you done that, and tell us a little bit more about this.
So actually we in the small manufacturing space that we have, we manufacture these low cost but very high quality sanitary napkins, and this is primarily because of the customer needs here. So we realize that the women that we employ are very, the producers are the consumers as well, right? So we understand their mentality. And what we find is that they want something that is an aspirational good.
Right.
Because pads are still something, kapra se kaam chala lete hain. But they want something, ki agar kapra se kaam nahi chalana hai, there has to be something that you look forward to using. So it has to be of this high quality. And so when we make these, we've made this and kind of designed this specifically for women that are rag users or cloth users and can transition to pads, but need that slow transition, because you suddenly can't be using something that feels completely different. But this is thicker, softer product. Which we are making this out of non-woven fabrics and wood pulp as well. So we have this pulverizing machine where it first pulverizes into the soft fluff.
Okay.
The soft fluff is then taken into our mini factory space where we are then measuring their weights and putting them into the shape of the rectangle that we want to make these pads.
Right.
We then layer them up with different layers like non-woven fabrics, tissue paper, blue sheets. And then we seal them on the sides, we sterilize them, and then we package them, and this is your package.
So that's the process. But so you talked about the fact that this one is different in that you're essentially trying to wean people away from using the cloth, and you're getting them to use the pads, but then you also have higher quality,
like this one,
product. Yeah, we have higher quality pads as well, and that's primarily because we cater to all kinds of women. So we cater to women that are first-time users. We cater to women that currently would want to use pads and have seen all these advertisements on TV and maybe occasionally using a combination of pads and cloth, but they don't have access to this on a regular basis. But they'd like to use something that they can go to college with, go to school with, and it'd be sleek. And so we have these, you know, more advanced products for them, yet at very affordable prices.
But that's the key, right?
Yeah.
The affordable prices, you might want to keep that.
I'll keep that.
The economics of it, how does that work? Because, and look, if you compare it to, even on our trip today, Aayush, we met a lot of women who say that they use a whisper or a, you know, mostly whisper.
I think surprisingly we met the three different sets of people who I guess Archana and Deborah meet regularly. The first one saying that we don't, you know, we already have another brand, we don't want it. The second one getting, you know, you can onboarding them as a new customer, getting a new customer. Right. The third one saying we only use cloth.
Yeah, we did get that one at the end. But yeah. But what I wanted to understand from you is how much cheaper is your product as compared to what you would get from the larger manufacturers? And how do you achieve that, really?
Yeah, so the more advanced product that we have is about 40% cheaper than what you can currently get in the market. And what we manufacture ourselves is the low-cost kind of a product. That's something that you can't get in the market.
Okay.
Because it is only locally made and it is locally given to women here. We're able to achieve those costs also because we have... we are spending very little on our overhead costs. Okay. Our admin costs are very low here. It is a small space, as you've already yeah. seen, and with the women that we work with. So we've been able to maintain that quality with that low cost for now. But if we want to now expand and go at scale, our costs would slowly increase. Mm. And that's why we're still being subsidized by donations for us to grow.
But you know, Swani, I yeah. want to understand that as well, because that's an insight we got with the deliveries as well, which is essentially that awareness is key, and awareness is perhaps the biggest issue. Like you said, even in urban slums, right here in the middle, in the heart of Mumbai, outreach is important. I'm hoping people watching this show know that stuff like this is happening in Mumbai. People are taking this initiative. But it also sort of helps when Akshay Kumar makes a Padman to know that, well, this is an issue that needs to be spoken about. It also helps when Meghan Markle visits this very office. Did that really help putting you on the map, and have a lot of people really, you know, been reaching out to you to put this story out and also see what they could do?
Taking this forward.
Yeah, for sure. I think there's a lot of elements to what you were just saying. Firstly, in terms of raising awareness, we try to raise awareness on the education bit as well, which is the basics. Yeah. So using a pad, using a cloth, how do you use one appropriately? Which products can you choose between? And then the disposal, which is why I'm holding these newspaper bags, is how do you dispose these sanitary napkins as well? Because we often find that that's a huge challenge in these communities. Now, when we want to raise awareness, we want to raise awareness about this whole ecosystem of things. So menstrual hygiene is not an isolated problem in the community. So if we're talking about disposal, we have to suddenly start also talking about waste management in general and how it's accumulated here.
Yeah.
And we're working in the same space and making a hygiene product, so it affects us, it affects the community.
Yeah.
So we need to be working on a whole range of issues. Mm. And I think that that's primarily what all of this press and Meghan Markle coming here has really helped with, is that we need the credibility to be working on a broader spectrum of problems and topics in communities. Mm. And now that we've received this kind of credibility and the stamp, it's like a thappa. Mm. You know, what they're doing is important work and these girls are on to something. That really helps us, because then we can go forward and say, you know, we actually need a daycare center in these communities, because all the women that are coming and working here have little children at home they need to take care of, and they're not able to work because they're sitting at home, and we need to provide this extra space for their children. It's a safe space with high quality education provided.
So
this, I think a lot of this attention has really been, now that what we're trying to do is kind of source it in the attention of what are the other projects that we can also conduct in different communities across the city.
So what I gleaned from that conversation is that this is the start. It started in 2011, then 2015. Yeah. And with this kind of movement that you've got going, you want to move from here to several other things. Can you very quickly tell us with regard to expanding this operation and also what else you'd like to do with Myna?
Yeah, so we've always had this vision that we want to be synonymous with affordable women's health at the doorstep. Affordable women's health has a lot of different elements to it. Menstrual hygiene is one icebreaker, where if you show a pad, it starts conversations. It starts many conversations where either a woman is shutting her door on your face, or you've seen women that are, you know, talking, no, I used this other thing, or they say something like, you know, I actually use only cloth because my husband doesn't let me buy the products. Mm. It starts conversations that link to other things and other problems.
Yeah.
We often find this leads to conversations even around sexual and reproductive health, where a woman says, a 28-year-old woman would say things like, I don't get my periods anymore. I haven't gotten them for years because I got my operation done, I got my uterus removed right after I had my second child, because she knows no other means of contraception.
Okay.
You'd find, and then you'd realize that, well, did you know about the other options? No, she was never aware. So we aim to be providing this kind of accurate information around all the different choices that women have, so that they have more agency to make their own decisions. And that's the women health seeking behavior that we want to kind of be able to develop here. So here women are only seeking healthcare in an emergency. So if somebody suddenly fractures themselves, or if somebody has cancer or TB and they suddenly need to go get treatment, that's the only time they remember a doctor. But here they should be constantly getting counseling support and know how should they be taking care of their own health, taking care of their own bodies. And that's what Myna is here for.
All right.
Interesting chat. But since Suhani said that, she said, if you actually are holding on one of these and you do reach out to people, which we are with this show, well, you start a conversation.
Absolutely, and I think on that note, do spread the word.
Absolutely, Sony, thanks so much for speaking to us.
Thank you. Thanks so much for coming and for selling.
Yes, and continue doing the good work that you and your team are doing.
Thanks so much.
Thanks so much for watching. Do stay tuned to Bloomberg Quint.